A very good evening to one and all. As in our earlier video, we had discussion on regular expressions. And also, we have gone through various examples, or we can say programming examples, where we have used different meta characters. I hope you have gone through all the programming examples which we had discussed in our earlier video. If not, I would like to suggest you to go through the earlier video before you can see this video, because in our earlier video we have discussed the meaning of meta character, different meta characters, and how we can use meta characters to extract string. Hence, I would like to suggest you to go through with that video once before you see this video, with the assumption that all of you have gone through the earlier video. I am going to start our next example, and if in this example we are going to check, or our intention is to extract only characters which are not digit. In our 16th program, if you observe, we are importing Ray library, and text is initialized to the rain in Spain. In find all, if you observe, I am saying slash capital D. The meaning of this is it should not match any digit, or we can say that it will extract all the characters which are from A to Z and which will not falls into 0 to 9. Hence, our text is having the rain in Spain and none of the character is digit. Hence, in an output we can see all the characters D H E R A I N I N S P A I N. All these are normal characters, and the functionality of capital D is opposite to small d. When we say small d, it will extract only digits. If we pass or if we say capital D, our intention is to extract other than digit character. Yes, for every character is other than digit, hence in an output we can see all the characters of text. And if condition is satisfied, due to that it will also print, yes, there is at least one match, after printing all the characters of our defined string text, that is the rain in Spain. In next example also, we are initializing the rain in Spain to the variable text, and after that we are saying small s. The meaning of that is it will match at every white space character. In our defined example, if you observe, we are having three spaces or white space. First white space is between the and rain word. Next white space is between rain and in word. Last white space is between in and Spain words. And find all will return three blank spaces. Hence, if condition is satisfied, in an output we can see three blank space, each one is separated by comma, and printf message, yes, there is at least one match. In this program, 18th program, again we have initialized same content, the rain in Spain to the text, and we are saying capital S. As we have studied, the functionality of capital S is opposite to small s. Small s will check for white space, whereas capital S extract all the characters other than white space. Hence, in an output we can see all the characters which are initialized to text other than white space. That is THERAININSPAIN in an output, and also as it matches to all the non-white space characters, if condition is true, along with that it will also display yes, there is at least one match. In our 19th program, the content initialized is same, the rain in Spain. Here we are saying slash small w. The meaning of w, as we have studied in our earlier video, it return a match at every word character that falls between A to Z or digits 0 to 9, and if it contains the underscore character. Yes, the rain in Spain is having all the characters and W is matched to all of them. Other than white space, all of them are displayed in an output screen. And also, if condition is satisfied, hence it prints, yes, there is at least one match. In our next example, again text is initialized to the rain in Spain. Again, as we know, the functionality of capital W is opposite to small w. It will extract other than characters, digits, as well as underscore. In this example, other than characters, digit and underscore, we have only three white space characters. Hence, X will be having three white space characters. And due to that, if condition is satisfied, in an output, we can see three white space characters. Along with that, a printf statement, yes, there is at least one match. In 21st program, we are initialized again text value as the rain in Spain and passing capital Z after Spain. It checks if the string ends with Spain or not. As per our example, yes, our text is initialized to the rain in Spain, and Spain is last word of initialized string. Hence, it returns Spain, and also as it matches to the word Spain, if condition satisfy and output, yes, there is a match. As we have discussed, if we specify anything between square brackets, it will match one of the character. If we specify any character, if we specify range, it will match between a specified range if any character falls into that particular range. In our 22nd program, we have initialized text with the rain in Spain, and we are finding is there string contains a characters A, R and N. Yes, the defined string contains A, R, N. For example, in rain, it matches R as well as A as well as N. In, it matches N. In Spain, again, it matches A, N. Hence, in an output, we can see R, A, N, N, A, N. Yes, it matches with specified characters A, R, N if condition satisfy, and it prints, yes, there is at least one match. In our next example, that is 23, again text is initialized with the string, the rain in Spain. Here our intention is to find all the characters which falls in the range of A to N in a defined string. Yes, defined string is containing a characters between A to N like H, E, A, I, N, A, I, N. Yes, it matches these many characters. Again, if condition satisfy, along with printing all the matched characters, it will also print, yes, there is at least one match. In our next program, again we have initialized text to the rain in Spain. Here our intention is to extract all the characters which are not either A, R or N. Apart from ARN, we are extracting all the characters. So hence in an output we can see THE, I, because it matches in rain R as well as A as well as N. Hence out of rain it will extract only I. Similarly in IN it will extract one more I. In Spain again it matches A and N. Hence it extract only SPI. As it matches these many characters, if condition is satisfied, and it will print, yes, there is at least one match. In our next example, our intention is to match to the only 0 to 3 numbers like 0, 1, 2, 3. But unfortunately, our defined string like the rain in Spain is not having any digits like 0 or 1 or 2 or 3. Hence, it will not match with any of the given string characters. Hence, X is having empty output. Due to that, if condition failed, it will execute else. Hence, in an output, we can see empty string along with no match output. This is very interesting. If you observe here, our text is initialized with 8 times before 11:45 a.m. and we are trying to extract all the digits between 0 to 9. Hence in an output we can see 81145. As it matches 5 digits, the if condition satisfy, along with that it prints, yes, there is at least one match. In our next example, again we have initialized text as a 8 times before 11:45 a.m. and this time it is beautiful. Try to understand. Here we are using two square brackets and we are mentioning 0 to 5 and 0 to 9. Means the range of your values will be between 00 to 59. Yes, 8 is having only single character, it is not matching first 8, that you can observe in an output. Because range is between 00 to 59, it will extract only those digits which are having a value of 2 digits, and that particular number should fall in the range 00 to 59. In our example, 11 and 45 falls in the range 00 to 59. Hence, in an output, it is printed 11 and 45. Even though, as a normal mathematics or range, we can say that 8 is between 0 to 59, but here we are matching 2 digit values only. As 8 is single digit, hence it is not considered 8. As it is extracted 11 and 45, the condition of if becomes true. Along with extracting 11 and 45, it is also printing, yes, there is at least one match. In our next example, we are having or initialize our text to 8 times before 11:45 a.m. and our intention is to extract only characters which falls in the range small a to z or capital A to z. Our intention is not to extract any digits. Hence in an output other than 8, 11:45, we can see all the characters like T I M E S B E F O R E A M. As it matches these many characters, if condition is also becomes true, it will print, yes, there is at least one match. As we have stated, in our next example, that is 29th, if you observe, we are using plus operator inside square bracket, and in our earlier video I have clearly stated that if you are using plus inside square bracket, it is not having a special meaning, which we will say like one or more occurrences. That special meaning will be nullified if you use plus operator inside square bracket. Then it will just try to match plus as a character, and it will search for given string. As our given string is having contained 8 times before 11:45 a.m. in initialized string, we are not finding plus symbol, hence our find all returns empty, and x is having empty value. Due to that, if condition failed, it will execute else block. In an output, we can see empty value along with no match statement. So I will stop here. In my next video, I am going to discuss a built-in functions like match, search, find all, split, as well as other built-in functions related to Ray library. Thank you. Thanks for watching video.